Hi YouTube, it's Tracy from Entrepreneur Girl, and today is Tracy's Tuesday Tips, and we are going to be talking about sales rank and other metrics that you should be looking at when considering products for your Amazon or eBay inventory. You know that I came to Indiana and was visiting with my parents when my father took critically ill. So I have stayed in Indiana and I am, at the hospital a lot and working closely with them and my father. So that's really sad, and that is why the late hour of this video post. And I just wanted to tell you this because my videos might be a little different in the next few weeks. I might have other people posting videos for me, or just in case something happens and I'm not able to get on YouTube. I just wanted to give you a heads up that that is going on in my life, and that will affect my channel, obviously. But I will try to maintain everything as well as I can. So I'm sorry for the late hour, but I'm really thankful to have posted at all, and I hope this video is helpful to you. I get a lot of questions about sales rank, so I just want to jump right in and make this as quick and informative as I can for you. So what is sales rank? Well, sales rank is a snapshot in time of it's an indicator of how well a product sells overall. So it doesn't really compare it to similar items. It just shows you kind of a snapshot on how the product's doing. And closer to one is best. Think number one is the number one product, and you want to be closer to one. And sales rank changes all the time on a daily basis. It can have huge fluctuations, and you need to know that when you're looking at a sales rank on this day, you're not really looking at the sales rank forever. It's not this long-term number. It can truly fluctuate day to day. And a perfect example is that of that is in another video, a Kohl's video that I did. I bought a Monster Inc. doll. I shipped one in. It had a great sales rank, great profit margin. I hung on to one. I was doing a video with it, and it was just a couple of weeks that I hung on to it. And then when I went to list it, the listing price had dropped, the rank had dropped. It was like a completely different product that I wouldn't have even purchased, just 2 weeks after the fact. So that's just how fast things fluctuate all the time. If there's a sale today, the sales rank is going to improve. If there are no sales today, then it's going to get worse. And that's just on today. So I just want you to kind of get in that mindset as we're talking about sales rank in this video. There's no set matrix. Amazon is pretty guarded about such things as, the buy box and how they calculate sales rank and everything. So there's not just, these numbers that we can plug in and figure out the perfect sales rank. So we're making guesstimates based on our experience as sellers, Keepa.com and CamelCamelCamel, and our pricing apps and our Amazon apps and our price calculators, and we're just using all of these tools to try to make the best decisions that we can as sellers in regards to purchasing our inventory. Every category is different. Books, I sell books at a much higher rank than I do, say, electronics, which needs to be much lower. So even within the categories, there's a lot of fluctuation. So we know that we have these huge swings and fluctuations, and that for us, what we need to do is we need to be looking at an item over time. We need to look at, a quarterly, a yearly, a monthly. These are all trends that we can look at and see how our product's doing over a long period of time versus what it's saying it's doing today. Is there a magical number? I'm just going to cut to the chase. That's what everybody wants to know. What is your sales rank, Tracy? What do you like? And I have said it in other videos, but I'll make it very clear on this one. And this is just my personal opinion. I like to buy products that are under 100,000 in ranking. I find that if I keep it under 100,000, that most of my items will sell, and most of them will sell within a month as a general guideline. So saying that, if I keep it around 50,000 or lower, generally all of my products will sell, and they will sell within 2 weeks' time. If you look at the Amazon bestsellers, most of those have a ranking under 500, and that is, the golden number is to be under a 500 ranking. But I buy products all the time, especially books that are up to 250,000. I typically won't go over 250,000 almost ever. So that seems to be my ceiling, but that is my breakdown as a general rule of thumb as far as ranking is concerned. So how important is ranking? I see two different spectrums. I see people that take it way too far. It's like the only thing that they focus on is ranking, and there's charts and there's graphs and they're paying people for cheat sheets, and it just kind of seems like overkill. I mean, ranking, yes, I believe it's important. Some people don't, I do, but I think it's important in the pie. I think it's important when taking consideration of other also important factors. Just looking at a product, like here on our page, we have Doggy Treats. We used Doggy Treats last week, so we're just sticking with that. And we're scrolling down here to product details, and you can scroll down here and see the best-selling rank. It's number 345 in pet supplies. Well, that's really good. You know, anytime you're just in the, you know, the hundreds, that's a pretty good sales rank. But then you're like, oh, wait, what's this? It's number six. Well, you know, that's awesome. Number six sounds terrific. And it is. It truly is. But these are subcategories, and they're not as important, and they're really not as accurate. So I tend not to even look at them. Most people aren't going to be searching under bones for dog treats. I mean, they do, but subcategories are great. It's a pleasant surprise for me, but I kind of tend to look at this number instead of that number, because this is, you know, the general overall category that it sold in, and that's 345, and that's really good. So I'm happy with that. But they look at that, and then they come up here and they look at the selling price, and this is low. So this is probably going to be Amazon. So we're going to look at all of the sales price, and we're going to scroll down here. Yep, sure enough, it's Amazon, and you can see that the next price here, you know, is $13, $14 for the primes, for the FBAers. So they look at those two things. They look at the profit that they're going to make by listing it. They look at the sales rank, and they buy their products based on that. And I think that's equally as dangerous. So I see people that are just looking at sales rank, or they're just looking at sales rank and, you know, in conjunction with the price. And I think that is an unhealthy place to be when considering your inventory, because you're purchasing a product on a snapshot of today's time. And for one, you're leaving a lot of longer tail products on the table, and there's a lot of money to be made in those. But number two, there's other considerations that you need to have, or you can actually be buying a product that is not going to sell as well for you as you might think. So what are the other pieces of the pie that we're talking about? We're going to run through those really quickly. So let's just go back to our main screen for our product and start at the top. Okay, so we're looking here at these dog treats. I look at the brand. This is Purina. Purina is well known. People like it, so that's good. And then I'm going to look at the five-star ratings, and I can see that this gets 4.5, which is really good, and I can even see the breakdown of that. And then I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to look at the reviews. We want a lot of reviews. Greater than 1,000 would be perfect. We also want to be looking at the recent reviews, but the higher the number of reviews, the better that it is. So we're going to scroll down here, and we're going to click see all reviews, and then we're going to scroll down, and we're going to click on most recent, because we don't want most helpful. And we can see here that we have July 27th, July 25th, July 22nd, 14th, 13th, 13th, 13th. So there's three on this day. And as you probably already know, for every review that you get, there's probably 50, I don't know, 500, 100 people that aren't leaving reviews. So the fact that we're getting, you know, 3 5-star reviews on the same day probably means that, you know, yes, this is accurate. It is selling a lot, and people are liking it. So we're looking at that. We're going to scroll down, and we're going to look at our competition. Competition is a big piece of the pie. How many people are we competing against? I'm going to click on free shipping. Here we go. How many competitors are Prime? One, two, three people are Prime. We have to compete against Amazon. That's important to know. So I want to know my competition. Last week I showed you how you can add to cart and you can do quantity 99 and it will tell you, say this triumphant treasures had three, it would say, you know, only three available. So you will know that once their three run out, they might be done and you would be on the table. You know, Amazon could have a whole lot more than that. And there's ways to check that out too. So we're going to add to cart. We're going to see how much our competition has as far as their product is concerned, how many people we're are competing against, and how many of those people are Prime. Those are all considerations that we have with our product. Consideration supply and demand. Things are obviously popular at different times. We touched upon frozen and how popular frozen's been, you know, this whole last year. And so that's a trend. Frozen's going to be popular for, and you're going to sell a lot of frozen items, and then all of a sudden they're not going to be popular anymore. They're going to be replaced with the next popular thing. Other trending things, fourth quarter, supply and demand. Again, you have a real popular toy, everybody's demanding it, the supply runs out, your prices go up out of the roof because everybody's fighting over your product. So these are important things to be mindful of and to be considering with your purchasing your inventory, because the time, like fourth quarter, our popularity, our supply and demand all affect how well and how fast your item is going to sell. Sales price. When you read a lot of literature and you're a freak like me and always researching, the best price area is between $7 and $40. And the reason they say that is because when you get under $7, and I've done other videos on this, your profit margin gets really thin, and it's kind of scary because the cost and the fees, it just narrows down your profit margin too slim, and it can get dangerous where you're actually losing money on a product that you're selling. But on the other end of that, if you get over the $40, then your initial investment is really high. You know, your cost of goods is substantial. If items get returned, you have a really big hit. But the main thing is that when they study the personalities of people and impulse buying and how they actually purchase products, they don't normally make a lot of $199 buys. It typically peters out after about $40. So they say the $7 to $40 range is the best range to sell a product. Here is Amazon best sellers. And the best sellers category, like we said, we want it to be, normally is under 500, and these are great. But you can go and shop by department on Amazon.com, and you can click any department that you want. Here I have clicked on toys and games, and then it will list all the best sellers in that category in that department on Amazon. And this is really helpful because you can scroll through this and get really familiar with this, especially if you're a newbie. And when you're going out retail arbitraging, you kind of have an idea, you know, what sells well, and they can catch your eye, and you could try to find them on clearance. You can Google it online and find out if anybody's having sales on these items, and it just kind of makes it, you know, nice. So I'm going to put a link up here to make it easier to find, but this is how you find it. It's this bestseller button here, and it's really for any department that Amazon has, so that's cool. Those are all the pieces of pie that we wanted to talk about. The last thing I wanted to share with you are some helpful sites. I've mentioned some of them before, like Camel, so I won't get into that, but they have Amazon price history charts that give, you know, a longer overview of how an item is trending, and you can see all the peaks and valleys and gauge, you know, average ranking for those items. So that's really helpful. And keepa.com, and I will pop over to eBay if I'm not getting enough information on the other sites, and I will see how well the product is selling here. The platforms are so similar. If it's really popular on eBay, most likely it's going to be really popular on Amazon. So that is everything that I wanted to talk to you about today. These sites are all free, so that's great. A lot of them you can get charts for monthly or quarterly or yearly. I like to keep it, monthly or quarterly, more recent activity. I don't really mess with the yearly too much. And I can't think of anything else I want to tell you. Sales rank is a common question. Everybody wants to know about it. Everybody kind of wants, a general guideline. And that's what I use. I can't say that it's perfect or the best, but it works for me. And I feel confident in sharing it with you. So I hope today's video has been helpful. And I look forward to our next video. And hopefully that'll be really soon. So thanks, guys. And I'll talk to you later.